Byral Creative Content Marketing. I don't know how to pronounce the word correctly. Maybe he'll explain to us how he put that word together. He's currently the Deputy Executive Creative Director of MRM Manila, the digital division of McCann World Group Philippines. His name is pronounced Budgette, but please don't ask him any questions about finance. He oversees a team of digital creatives, a mix of copywriters, art directors, designers, techno geeks, net freaks, and even mad scientists. Together with two creative directors, they handle the digital campaigns of some of the top brands in the Philippines: Coca-Cola, Nescafe, Cream Silk, Coffee Mate, Maggi, KitKat, Bank of the Philippine Islands, San Miguel Beer, and Jollibee, just to mention a few. Their creative achievements was one of the reasons why MRM Philippines was awarded Digital Agency of the Year in the Philippines AOY Awards and the Campaign Asia AOY Awards. Budgette was also a finalist in the 2012 Southeast Asia Creative of the Year Campaign Asia Awards. In between all of that work, he still manages to write graphic novels. His creator-owned crime horror comic book, Trece, won Best Graphic Literature in last year's Philippine Book Awards. Now I remember where I first met him, where he guested it on a show talking about the book, not about marketing. But here he is to give us more of his nuggets of knowledge. Deputy Executive Creative Director for MRM Manila, Budgette Tan.
Thank you. Hello, good afternoon, good evening. I promise to get you out of here in 30 minutes so we can all get drunk. This was assigned to me. I hope we can all get drunk. I hope there's enough alcohol. So this was assigned to me, and I'm trying to interpret it. I was trying to figure out, you know, it's more of how do you get people to talk about your brand and make them buy your product. And if we had the secret to viral marketing, we'd be very, very rich now, and everyone else would close down. So we'll try to answer that by taking a look at what makes your brand story go viral. What makes your brand story spread? So we'll take a look at how memes work. But before we get into that, I will ask for your participation. It's a really quick quiz. I will show you a bunch of words, and if you know what these words mean, please just yell them out loud, okay? So first word is... Next word. Is it wind of... No, it's not. Next. Next. All right, next is... Nice. Next. All right. Gets more difficult. What's this? Nice. Wow. Alam nyo lahat, no? Oto. Let's see if you know this. Make out with feelings. Importante yon, guys. With feelings. Okay? Considering you know all of these words, and my diagnosis that you have all been infected, you've been all infected with a meme. And we toss this word around a lot. We call it meme, but it is pronounced meme. If you are Greek, then you have the license to pronounce it as meme, because that's where it came from. Dictionary definition, kids. An idea, behavior, or style that spreads from person to person within a culture. Richard Dawkins is the guy who came up with the word meme, because he thought a gene is how you spread biological information. That's how a child gets the traits of, you know, his mom and dad. So, but in culture, what is the unit of information that gets spread around? So he just said, well, I want it to rhyme with gene, and the Greek word mimeme actually means to imitate or to borrow. So he thought, I'm going to call it a meme. And yes, Mr. Richard Dawkins has been turned into a meme himself already. As far as we're concerned, this is what we're very, very familiar with. Internet memes that look something like this. This would be great if Cornetto really thought of this campaign. I think this will make a comeback with Thor 2 happening soon. And then there's this. And then there's this. He does have a movie, by the way, on the job. He doesn't look like that. I will take a guess on who will be the next big internet meme. It's going to be... And how fast do you think people will turn her into a meme in 5, 4, 3, 2, and she's a meme? And one more. Pinoy talaga, ang Pinoy malakas mang Alaska pero umpikon din natin. Something to be discussed for something else. So, going back to a meme. So, it's not just funny stuff that you put online. If you think about it, again, going back to how is information passed on from generation to generation, looking back at the original intent for creating Levi's jeans, it was supposed to be an outfit for workers. It needed to be sturdy. It needed to be able to survive the rigors of what a farmer goes through or what a miner goes through. And there was a certain point in time when people of a certain stature or class didn't want to be caught dead wearing jeans. Pang masa lang yan, pang trabahador lang yan pagsuot ng jeans na yan. But as years went by, it started to be considered cool. Something really interesting is also Sid Vicious, who became known, who is the from the rock band Sex Pistols. He became known for wearing clothespins on his, you know, on his outfits. So a lot of the kids of the punk era started to copy his look. And when they were asked, you know, how do you think of this really cool look? He said, oh, it's really just because I didn't have money to buy another pair of jeans. I just needed to put, that's why I started to use clothespins. So what was supposed to be a utility suddenly became fashion, taken to an extreme sometimes. Or something even more interesting is this word. And if I change the spelling of one letter, it suddenly is the Spanish word for a small boatload of people. So meaning somewhere in the past couple of hundred years, it was a functional way of describing, uy, may parating na barkada, a small boatload of people. But suddenly, through the generations, it started to mean your closest group of friends. So the question is, how do you make your brand story memetic? How do you make it spread? There are three, I take a look at it as three simple things we are probably all aware of, but let's take a look at some examples that emphasize it. Of course, it needs to be shared. It needs to be something that it needs to be something that the brand will share first and that we will share afterwards. These days, we click like all the time. But if you think about it, take a step back, and before you click like again, think about why are you hitting like on this particular content? It's not simply because you like it. Sometimes you like it because it made you laugh out loud. Sometimes you click like because it made you go, what the, yeah, or for the win. Or you see something that makes you proud to be a Pinoy and makes you go for the win. Or you see something that actually you have no words for. You click like because there is an emotional response that is triggered from you, and that is what we need to do. We can't just put up bland information on our pages, on our websites, or whatever it may be, and think that people will spread it. We need to provoke an emotional response. For example, if the task given to us is to help educate people on the benefits of on how to do CPR, this is one way to do it.
Hi, my name is Av Rios, and I'm a paramedic with Lansing Mercy Ambulance on behalf of Expert Village. In this clip, we're going to use the different steps and techniques that we've gone over previously and put them together to use one possible scenario that you might run across in real life. Sir, can you hear me? Sir, can you hear me? No response. Call 911. I'm going to open the airway. Look, listen, and feel for 10 seconds. I don't see or feel any breathing. I'm going to go ahead and give a ventilation now. And I have adequate chest rise. I'll give a second ventilation.
You now know what to do if you see an unconscious manananggal on the street. And I can see some of you have walked out because of that video. So, come back! Or we can try this.
My name is Vinnie Jones, and I'm going to teach you a lesson you'll never forget. There are times in life when being tough comes in handy. Say some geezer collapses in front of you. What do you do? We need a volunteer that ain't breathing. Here's one I made earlier. First thing you do is you check him over. If he ain't responsive or he ain't breathing, or he's making noises like this, then his heart will stop working, he's having a cardiac arrest. Look lively. First call 999. Then you do hands-only CPR and no kissing. You only kiss your missus on the lips. Watch. Lock your fingers together, knuckles up. Then push down, right on the sovereign. Push down 5 or 6 centimetres. That's about 2 inches in old money. Push hard and fast, about 2 times a second. Like to the beat of staying alive. Worried you'll hurt him? Better a cracked rib than him kicking the bucket. Keep this up till the ambulance arrives. So don't forget, check him over. Call 999, push hard and fast to staying alive. It works. Hands only CPR. It ain't as hard as it looks. If you want to come in handy in an emergency, why not sign up for one of our Heart Start courses?
The first video got, 300 hits. This one got 3 million on the first weekend. And 1 year later, they showed case studies of people that actually got saved because they watched this video. A year later, they then came up with a video teaching kids how to do the same thing in case an adult or a friend suddenly collapses. So, same piece of information, but the other one is more viral, more mimetic. It presented to you new things. It made you suddenly realize, oh, I don't need to do mouth-to-mouth to save someone, although I'm sure you're thinking of, this is my chance now to kiss that girl. But, and it made you remember something very important by using a song. And that's what made the video spread even more and ended up helping a lot of people. I will now show you a promo, which you might be familiar with. But as a good example...
Yes! Yes!
This is the world's best day.
Slurpee has always been the different drink. You can mix, pour, blend, and fill the cup any way you like. But in 2011, our biggest competitor declared a cold war with a major push of their copycat product. We needed to make ourselves different again. So we changed the one thing that's always been the same. The cup. Bring your own cup day. Yep, for one day, we gave the nation total creative control. We invited them to fill up anything they wanted for the price of a medium Slurpee. And it wasn't long before they started seeing potential cups everywhere. If you could love the world, the best suggestions were turned into an outdoor, in-store, and print campaign to inspire people in the lead-up to the day. And to build further anticipation, a guerrilla stunt hijacked other brands' advertising. One day out from the event.
Oh, I told us too much.
We've seen people drinking out of briefcases, gum boots, and watering cans.
Every store in the nation participated, with over 80,000 customers served. That's a new cup every 1.8 seconds. Sales were up 270%. More than 320,000 litres were sold. Almost every machine was slurped dry. And the fans responded by producing more content in one day than they had in the brand's history. Uploading over 30 new photos and videos every minute.
BYO Cup Day is like awesome.
BYO Slurpee, best idea ever.
So this is a very good day.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks.
Most importantly, Slurpee's still Australia's favourite frozen drink. Pretty good for a day's work. Woo-hoo.
that promo would have worked if they said, buy one, take one. 50% off today. Suddenly, by making the you know, what you can drink it from more interesting, allowed it just spread by itself, and people started to upload the pictures and did their own did the marketing for the brand itself. Really quickly, I want to show you something that only Jeans came up with. They wanted to promote their new line for the season, and what they did was they came up with a movie, a short film. I'll just show you the first 60 seconds of this film. And as you watch the film, you'll see that you can interact with it.
Sometimes you just know something needs to happen. With pretty little houses all in a row. It was sleepy and dull. And nothing ever happened. That's the way people liked it.
So at any point in the video, you could actually click on the clothes of the characters, find out what it's called, and actually go and buy the clothes.
Afternoon,
or share them on your social network. IKEA did something similar. What they did was they created a music video of a party set inside a kitchen. They uploaded the video on YouTube, and what they did was they put annotated links on every single piece in that kitchen. Meaning if I click on that piece, it then leads me back to the IKEA site where I could actually purchase that exact product. Something that we recently did this year is called Edgar. The very simple task given to us was to tell people that the Nescafe 3-in-1 original now had 20% more content in it. So, of course, if we were in the day and age of YC Bikini Brief and Seiko Seiko Wallet, we'd just keep repeating that message, or we'd just yell it out loud. The problem is, once the moment you step into, you go to a sari-sari store, you go to a convenience store, you're confronted with all of this. And then, of course, there's also the situation that even Nescafe itself has a lot of variants, but we wanted people to focus on Nescafe 3-in-1 original. At the same time, we wanted them to remember that Nescafe is all about, you know, what happens when people come together for coffee, that it's the start of something interesting or something inspiring. So this is what we did.
Mga Ginoo! Ako si Princesa Esmeria.
Wow! It's a chicks!
Nasa pangalimang niyong planeta! Nako! Andiyan na siya!
Ah! Ako! Sa Repulso! The Cosanian! Ako pinakadabi! The whole universe!
Oh no! That's a big robot!
Ikaw lang, prinsesa. Papakitaan namin ito ng bigger at bolder na lakas. Akala mo small time, yun pala big. Akala mo kupas, pero yun pala great. Akala mo di kaya, yun pala may paraan. Akala mo mahina, pero yun pala may
laban! Enter!
Nyo? Epic hail! You're such a loser!
Ah! Oras na para ilabas ang ating the best na sandata!
Tama!
Mag-transform! Nescafe 3-in-1 original! Bigger! Bolder ang sarap! Activate! Akala mo luma, yung pala bago. Akala mo all nuts, yung pala panalo. Akala mo dati the best sa classic. Akala din nila ngayon mas kape-kape! Akala mo na-try mo na ang the best na coffee sa tindahan. Ngunit may mas masarap dyan. May mas masarap dyan.
Mas kaping kape! 20% mas pinarami!
Ako rin! My secret weapon! I summon the trident of doom!
Matakot ka!
Ultra
Pre, kape ka muna. Mukhang masama lang araw mo.
The bass is like a toe.
Huwag kang matapot na baka magkamali. Walang mapapala, hindi ka magbaka sakali dahil lumilipas ang oras. Baka ka maiwanan kung hindi mo susubukan.
So when we did a survey and asked them, so what do you remember from the video? Of course, they remember that it's now more. They remember this moment when the robots started to have coffee. They remembered it was because of the aroma of the coffee that the fight came to a stop. And nicely enough, they remembered 20% more. It helped that we casted these guys, who also had a very big following in the respective social networks. So not only were we using YouTube to promote the video, we were using their own networks and their own fans to lead them to the video. So resulting to 1.5 million views in a week, getting shared all over Facebook and Twitter. When we took a look at it, 30% were organic views, which we think is coming from because of the endorsers. And taking a look at that time when no other Nescafe commercial was running, it did contribute a 7% increase in their sales. When we were asked, taking a look back on, you know, what made it effective, I just remember a Thai creative director said, "What makes a campaign successful? It's three important ingredients. It's entertainment, entertainment, entertainment." And I think that's one of the things that helped drive this particular video. Take a look at what Coke in the US is doing in terms of providing content entertainment for teens. What they've developed are 61 sites. So you can go to ah.com, and then if you go to ahhh.com, it brings you to another game. And if you go to ah.com, it brings you to another game. So these are very simple games that have already contributed to like 4 million worth of traffic going to these different games. So different ways, different reasons on why you should share it. You're entertained by it, you love it, you want other people to experience it. How else can the meme spread is if we allow people to adapt it and making it part of something that they did by themselves. This is Donald Lim. No, not really. So yes, we all know Donald Lim. Is he still here? Donald Lim made this song popular. Ay, sorry, jo, wala siya. Nasa labas ka na kanina eh. So si Sai nga pala to. Sorry. So Sai made this popular, a billion views, which of course got copied by so many other Filipinos. And they adapted it. And each of these videos got roughly like a million hits, a million views as well. What was interesting was that they didn't just copy it frame by frame. They made it Pinoy. And that's what made it spread. Pinoys loved the original video, but if you just copied it, then why should I want to watch an exact copy? But since they put in all of these Pinoy elements, it also helped spread, well, at least made them popular and made the song popular as well. A campaign that did this pretty well, of course, is More Fun in the Philippines, wherein they first launched three ads talking about what is More Fun in the Philippines, whether it's commuting, status updates, and then people started to do their own jokes. Once they understood how the joke worked, they started to upload social climbing More Fun in the Philippines, changing ads, Finding Nemo, or Stretch Limos. So we need to allow them to adapt, and we can give them the tools, of course. What DOT did was they came up with an app where you could upload the picture and put in the font, but that didn't stop people from doing it even before the app got put up. one of the recent examples was, of course, in Pacific Rim, you could create your own Jaeger. And of course, the Pinoy started to upload their own versions of Jeepney Danger instead of Gypsy Danger. So you just need to be open and allow people to play around with your brand story. The next level is, can you make them adopt it into their lives? Not just play around with it for an hour or a day, but make them experience it on an everyday basis. The most basic example of this is what we're doing right now when we handle communities on Facebook. Since people log into Facebook every day, if we have relevant content for them, they will interact with your brand on a daily basis. And as mentioned numerous times throughout the past 2 days, if we talk to them like they were our friends, then they will engage with us more. On the Nescafe page, we post simple stuff like this about what goes well with your coffee, and it gets a ridiculous amount of likes and shares. Something we did for Alpo was we wanted to talk to dog owners and tell them that there's a right type of food for your dog. So we thought, let's make the dog give that message. So we created Toffee, and the entire page is being run by Toffee the dog, telling them on what's good to eat so that they can get a bite out of the good life. Most basic on what's happening now on Facebook. Let me now show you 3 more examples on how we can make them feel like they've been adopted into a community of people who like what they like, who think what they think. If you're familiar with Post Secret, it all started out as a simple blog. He asked people to send in their deepest, darkest secrets, but it needed to be in the form of a postcard. So people started to send in these things that they've never told anyone, but finally they were glad that they had a way to release this to the world without getting into trouble. And you had your fair share of funny stuff, heartbreaking stuff, and kilig stuff like this. He got so many secrets that he eventually started to release them as books. And eventually, so from a simple blog to something as analog as this, he went back to the digital space and came up with an app for it.
Everybody has secrets. There are dirty secrets, soulful secrets, shocking, sexy, and silly secrets. There are secrets that might haunt you, and secrets that can heal you. There are secrets you can't let go of, and secrets that won't let go of you. Love notes, daydreams, confessions, regrets. These secrets can change who you are. But the funny thing about secrets is, sometimes it's better when you share them. Introducing the Post Secret app. Discover secrets from your neighborhood, your school, your city, your world. Anonymously share your own secrets with a simple photo or sentence. Share secrets. No secrets. Post Secret.
30,000 secrets uploaded on a daily basis, nearly 1 million secrets being uploaded on a monthly basis. Wouldn't that be fantastic for your brand to be able to get 1 million engagements on a monthly basis? Post Secret made them feel that they were not alone with that particular secret. People had written in and said, because they had read that particular secret, it stopped them from committing suicide because it didn't make them feel so alone in the world. So suddenly, if we can make them feel that they are part of something bigger, or maybe even like a small little group, it can actually, they will help spread your brand story themselves. On the other end of the spectrum, so something as simple as a little blog like this with a simple app like that, let's take a look at what Red Bull has started to do. They have started to generate their own content. So if you go to Red Bull Media House, these are all, and of course the most popular stunt that they did past year was the guy who jumped from space. But aside from that, that's what led people to this site, where if you love content that gives you that adrenaline rush, then this is where you go. They've branched off to stuff on print, on mobile. They've even started to produce their own music. It leads you to things that give you that adrenaline rush, like so. So it's an interesting So it's interesting for me that a product or a brand like Red Bull has branched off into this. It would be interesting to see if a Philippine brand would eventually start to do this on a more regular basis and not just necessarily on an anniversary or in a special occasion. Right now, this is what's driving traffic and awareness and brand love for Red Bull, by doing all of these things. Lastly, last two examples, and then we can all go and get drunk. Can we? So the next level is, can you push the brand message so much, make the people love your brand so much that you make them, it becomes part of their culture and maybe even part of tradition? This is what Macy's did for Christmas. And if you're familiar with this, I'll just show you two more videos, and then we're all done. This is what they did in 2009 to launch it.
In 1897, a little girl named Virginia O'Hanlon wrote a letter to the New York Sun newspaper. She asked if Santa Claus was real. The newspaper's response remains the most famous editorial in history. Yes, Virginia, there is a Santa Claus. Fast forward to 2008. The Yes, Virginia editorial inspires Believe, a holiday campaign for Macy's. Quoting those famous words, we asked Americans to prove they believed by writing their own letter to Santa Claus and mailing it at any Macy's nationwide. Believe meters across the country tracked our progress, and by Christmas, we had collected over 1.1 million letters. Our challenge for 2009 was to build on that success. We knew we could inspire more people to believe if we told Virginia's story beyond the confines of traditional advertising. So we went to CBS, America's number one network, with a pitch. A primetime 30-minute animated Christmas special based on the true story of Virginia O'Hanlon. A show to become a perennial holiday event like Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade and Miracle on 34th Street. A special crafted in the spirit of the old holiday classics and centered on our campaign idea, Believe. On December 11th, 2009, that pitch became reality. In just 37 weeks, half the production schedule of a typical animated show, we created a living, breathing New York circa 1897. We invented a motley cast of characters to help Virginia on her quest.
Ho, ho, ho!
And hired some famous voices to bring them to life.
Santa, hey?
Yes, Virginia incorporated elements of the Believe campaign, like the Believe meter and the red letter box. But more importantly, we crafted the story entirely around our campaign's message.
Believing in Santa isn't something you prove. It's something you do.
We didn't just make the show. We had to promote it as well. Our PR outreach generated over 1.8 billion media impressions. Macy's declared December 11th National Believe Day. Everything built to the night of the premiere. So, did anyone tune in? The show drew over 3.7 million viewers, beating every other network but one. And the reviews were among the best of any new animated special in years. As an entertainment property, Virginia is just getting started. This year we'll see a children's book, a DVD release, even a parade balloon. That's why we set out to make a Christmas classic instead of another ad. In 1897, Virginia O'Hanlon showed the world what it means to believe. Our hope is that her story will continue to inspire long into the future.
Thank you. So they had the cartoon the following year. It actually beat Law and Order and became the number one show for that particular time slot. They had the DVD, they had the storybook, so the meme was spreading, right? But they needed to find another way to make that meme, to make that brand story spread even more, and maybe even make it more personal for the kids. So here's what they did the following year.
The lights, the costumes, the nervous jitters. Every kid should experience the thrill of performing on stage. But right now, school drama programs need our help. So this year, Macy's is giving teachers and students a little holiday magic. We've written and scored this brand new musical specifically for the school stage, and any school in the country can stage it, royalty free. Adapted from the critically acclaimed animated special, Yes, Virginia, the musical is based on the true story of a little girl who taught the world to believe.
What is wonderful is seeing Virginia and Ollie and Charlotte come to life as real kids, and seeing what these wonderful actors have done with the roles and made it their own. You know, I wrote the words and I had visions in my head, and now to see it on stage with real people doing it, it's quite astonishing, actually.
At YesVirginiaMusical.com, teachers will find everything they need to put on a great show, from scripts and scores to costume design, to a musical school with great advice from some famous faces. To make these shows even more magical, the first 100 eligible schools will receive a $1,000 grant from Macy's to bring their productions to life.
It's been a lot of fun.
It's really fun.
Be one of the first to bring this holiday tradition to the stage and help us prove that
Yes, Virginia, there is a Santa Claus.
Support theater in schools and spread the message of believing. Yes, Virginia, the musical. Coming soon to a school near you.
So it's interesting how they started out with an activation which was just a red letter box. They made kids submit letters to Santa, moved it, and created content, which was the Yes, Virginia cartoon. And finally, had the kids portray the story themselves. So you can now imagine all of these kids have formed this bond with this particular storyline, which they will, you know, grow up with as memorable moments of Christmas time. So really simply put, we need to find a way to make the brand story shareable. And of course, it needs to hit an emotional spot for them to share it, to at its most basic like it first, to really love it. It's also possible they might hate something so much they'll spread it. And then allow them to adapt it, play around with it. We should give them that freedom. And eventually they will make it part of their everyday lives. Or maybe even if you do it right, it can become part of tradition and culture. One last thing. Something to keep in mind as we create all of these content, not just as a single one-off video, but something when you take a look at the plans for the year or the plans for the next 5 years, we need to take a look at it not just as marketing people and as advertising people. I think we now need to take a look at it from the point of view of these people. We need to imagine ourselves as the editor-in-chiefs of a magazine where we're thinking of what is the cover story, what is the feature, what is the interview and review, but it just happens to be in the form all happening on the digital space. We need to take a look at ourselves as network program directors, thinking of what right shows, content will make my brand story spread. We need to think ourselves as studio producers, thinking of what is the right kind of elements that I need to put into this particular story that becomes part of the bigger story and make it spread even more. Thank you very much for listening.
Before we let you go and get drunk, you gotta sit down. Because I'm sure there are a lot of people out here who, aside from them hungry and thirsty for a drink, they got engaged and they have some questions to ask. We do have the mics. There you go. First up, sir, go ahead.
Hello? Okay. I'm Freddy from Fleischmann Hillard. I would just like to ask, the success of viral materials is for it becoming organic or authentic. My concern is when regulation comes in. So when should we apply for ASC clearance for viral materials? Or should we apply for it?
No. I mean, as long as I think, I mean, that's always been brought up, and internally on our side, we do still keep in mind ASC rules, actually, as much as possible. Of course, again, like I said earlier, ang Pinoy pikun. So at any point that, you know, your competitor can, I think, you know, launch a complaint against you, we will. So as much as possible, yeah, you know, there's no, I don't think it helps to come up with a message that you know, that says anything negatively about your competitor, although I'm sure some people will try that. But as far as, you know, if you are a big brand, then why would you want to go down that direction? So I think it's still self-policing at right now, and since in the back of our heads we know the ASC rules, then we still follow that.
What, sir? Oh, he was just fixing his seat. Sorry about that. Ginigil mo kasi sa inom, eh.
Oh, sorry.
All right. While they're gaining their momentum for what questions you want to ask, you mentioned something very interesting, something that we touched on earlier with the other speakers and specifically with Donald, talking about how you can argue about the ROI a bit. Sorry to bring it back to the point. You Nescafe, sabi mo, 7% increase sales because nothing else happened that week. Was this intentional to not run anything else and see how this would go? Or nagkataon lang?
Yeah, it just so happened at that particular time. They already came out with a TV commercial earlier in the year, but the new development, at least for that particular point of the quarter, was, again, the bigger SKU. So at that point, everything was just happening on the digital space, so it was interesting to see what would happen on sales-wise. So it was really nice to find out that it did affect, you know, a little bump there.
Would you dare other brands to try it for 7 days?
Absolutely.
You would,
It would be great to... I mean, because that's always been the question. It is very, very difficult, and to actually say, because of this, you know, sales went up. It was interesting to see the examples of Inity where it would give you a coupon, or, I mean, that would be the most, you know, the strongest link to say they saw it online, they clicked it, they went to the store. Mm-hmm. So, but aside from that, if it was just content, then I think that would be a good experiment to do.
All right. Go ahead.
Budgette, is there a translation?
Para madinig po ng iba.
Just a quick question. What you've said is fantastic. Those are more or less consistent with the marketing rules. But do you have any kind of translation for mobile for those things?
For mobile?
Yeah.
I when I was putting together this presentation, I did have some mobile examples, but I just wanted to focus on content creation that we get and the content that we view on the web, whether it is on Facebook or on websites. Probably the closest that comes to that is what Post Secret has done. If you think about it, Post Secret is Instagram, but with that filter of secrets. In a way, you're still looking at user-generated content, but on a mobile platform. So I guess that comes close to it. So far, right now, I think most of the stuff that's seen on a website can be viewed on a mobile site. So it would be interesting to see companies start to develop things specifically for mobile. And probably the other thing that comes close to content on mobile are review apps. So we've been seeing a couple of apps that are Manila-based or Philippine-based where it tells you these are the good places to go to, and these are like content generated by the users themselves. So far it's on that level. I guess Coke, all of those games that I quickly showed you were also available for mobile. So those are, I guess, some examples that where content can engage them on a mobile level.
Is this where we're going, Budgette? UGC, user-generated content. Hey, this morning our boss said he's opening up 5 indie producers to be produced by ABS-CBN, you know, and Facebook and all those memes on YouTube. Is it an accepted trend right now? You can hold back from your own internal creativity and see what your fans and your consumers want to dish out there?
I mean that has been happening for quite some time, and it's always good to see how they can play around with your brand. I think the more interesting thing to look at is what Red Bull is doing, because they are now, instead of, for example, Red Bull sponsoring a race or Red Bull sponsoring a triathlete competition, they've now created their own. So I think that would be the more interesting space to look at, because you will still forever have people making their own content, as we saw with the Thor memes. I mean, that came from nowhere. I think Thor was just showing on HBO that night, and that's why people started to make Thor memes. So, but if you can channel that and make them really do the content specific to a particular campaign, then that's great timing for us.
All right. Any other questions out there? I don't want to hold you all back from wherever you have to go. He wants a drink. All right. Round of applause. Budgette, thank you so much.